Okay, children, now we are going to see the 5th standard English about the poem Why. Why means, this is about the poem about why you ask the question, why is the sky blue? Why is the sky blue? Is sky blue? So, there are so many questions like this. Why is the earth round? Why is the earth round? Okay, why is the earth round? So everything is a question. Why is silk soft? Is silk vandu soft ah irukku? There are so many questions like this unga manasla theriyum. Why is fire hot? Why is fire hot? Think, yosinga. Why is it so? ஏன் எல்லாமே இப்படி இருக்குது? Why is it so? So in the questions-ல answer, if you are going to the higher classes, you might have come to know that according to the science. Why is the sky blue? Why is the earth round? Why is silk soft? Why is fire hot? Think, why is it so? Then, why does the river flow? Why does the river flow? ஏன் நதி ஓடிக்கொண்டே இருக்கிறது? Why does the river flow? Then, why does the wind blow? Why does the wind blow? Why does the wind blow? Okay. Then, why does the sun shine? Why does the sun shine? Why does the rain pour? ஏ மழை பெய்யுது? Why does the rain pour? Think, why is it so? Think, why is it so? Okay. Then, let us seek. Let us seek. Okay. With questions all week. So, ஒவ்வொரு வீக்கும் நம்மளுக்கு different different questions வரும். With questions all week. As we grow, நீங்கள் வளர வளர ஒவ்வொரு க்வெஸ்சனுக்கா you might have come to know the answer. With answers to know. With answers to know. Think. So this is the poem for you. Why is the sky blue? Why is the earth round? Why is silk soft? Why is fire hot? Think. Why is it so? Why does the river flow? Why does the wind blow? River ஏன் ஓடிக்கொண்டே இருக்கிறது? Then why does the wind blow? ஏன் காற்று இருக்கிறது? Then why does the sun shine? Then why does the rain pour? Think. Why is it so? Then let us seek with questions all week. As we grow with answers to know, think. So this is the poem. And yeah, they are given the glossary also. So note down this. So நீங்கள் பெரிய கிளாஸ் போக போக உங்களுக்கு இந்த க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ்க்கு எல்லாமே ஆன்சர்ஸ் தெரியும். யூ மைட் ஹவ் லேர்ன்ட் சாஃப்ட், திஸ் இஸ் ஸ்மூத், ப்ளோ, ப்ளோ மீன்ஸ் ஏ சடன், எதிர்பார்க்காத நேரத்தில் வீசுவது சடன், ஷைன் தட் இஸ் பிரைட், pour, pour means flowing. Okay, soft is smooth, blow is sudden, shine is bright, and pour flowing. Now the next one is match the rhyming words.
First one is flow. Second one, grow. And third one, seek. So here you can write no. They have written the answers. They have changed the answers and they are written. So you can write flow. Blow is the first answer. And grow is no. And seek is weak. Okay. And now list the questions which you seek answer using why. List. உங்களுக்கு தெரிஞ்ச questions. Why in your questions கேட்கணும் இல்லையா? List questions. To which you seek. To which you seek answer using why. Why? So all these are page number 80. Page number 79. Page number 79 this is, okay. So here some of the questions they ask you, why is ice cold? Then why does the bamboo grow tall? Why does the bamboo grow tall? So adanda unga 5 space koduthirukanga. Why does the bamboo grow tall? Then why is sea water salty? Why is sea water salty? Okay, so like this you can ask so many questions. Why are the clouds white? Clouds were a sky there. Why are the clouds white? Then why is the blood red in color? Why is the blood red in color? Like this, you can ask so many questions. Why is the blood red in color? Okay, so this is about the poem and the poem exercises in your book. If you got the book, take your book and note down the answer in this. And now, next we'll move on to the grammar part, that is describing words. Let us know. This page number. So memorize the poem, children. That is also very easy. Only why the question kittirukanga. So memorize the poem. So in this, let us know page number. Let us learn describing words. So describing words is also known as the adverbs. That is, add something to the verb. Page number 81. Okay. So he rides his bicycle carefully. For example, he rides his bicycle carefully. Okay. He rides his bicycle carefully. He rides his bicycle. When he rides his bicycle, if he falls down, he rides his bicycle carelessly. கேர்லெஸ்ஸாக ஓட்டிட்டு போனால் என்ன ஆகும்? கீழே தான் விழணும். ஓகே, ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் கேர்ஃபுல்லி, கேர்லெஸ்லி, தீஸ் ஆர் த டிஸ்கிரைபிங் த வேர்ப். தி அபவ் சென்டென்ஸ் டெல்ஸ் அஸ் அபவுட் த ஹவ் வி ரைட்ஸ் இஸ் பை சைக்கிள். ஸோ இந்த சென்டென்ஸ் என்ன தெரியுது, அவங்க எப்படி சைக்கிள் ஓட்டினாங்க. ஸோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் ஈ ரைட்ஸ் இஸ் பை சைக்கிள் கேர்ஃபுல்லி, ஜாகிரதையாக ஓட்டினான். நெக்ஸ்ட் ஈ ரைட்ஸ் இஸ் பை சைக்கிள் கேர்லெஸ்லி, ஸோ ஹீ ஃபெல் டவுன். ஸோ கேர்ஃபுல்லி கேர்லெஸ்லி, தட் இஸ்
such words that describe an action or a verb. So or a verb vandu or action solumbodhu and the action eppadi nadandhadu carelessly carefully describe pannadhu verb are called adverbs. Words that describe words that describes describe an action or verb. Okay, words, the action or verb, and the action or illa the verb describe pandrathu are called adverbs. Are called adverbs. Okay. So an adverb describes a verb. So it describes. Enna verb describe pannana, we have to ask a question like this. How tells. And the verb enna solduna. How, eppadi nadandhadu. When, eppo nadandhadu. Where, inge nadandhadu. So this we have to ask these three questions for the adverb. If he rides his bicycle carefully. How, eppadi nadandhadu. Carefully nadandhadu. When, inge nadandhadu. On the road he rides his bicycle. How, where and how often. And innonu vandu and how often. How often. Okay. So indha maari neengale questions ketukkanum. So an adverb is a word that describes and describes a verb and tells how, when, where and how often. Adikadi nadandhadu appdinu sollanum. Suppose here how varumbodhu she walks slowly. She walks slowly. அப்போ நம்ம என்ன கேட்போம், இதில் அட்வர்ப் கண்டுபிடிக்கணும்னா எப்படி நடந்தாங்க. ஹவு ஷி வாக் ஸ்லோலி. அப்போ ஹவு டஸ் ஷி வாக், ஹவு டஸ் ஷி வாக், தட் இஸ் ஸ்லோலி. கேன் யூ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட். தென் ஈ ஜாயின் த டியூட்டி எஸ்டர்டே. ஈ ஜாயின்ட், எப்போ ஜாயின் பண்ணாங்க. வென் ஈ ஜாயின், ஈ ஜாயின் த டியூட்டி எஸ்டர்டே. இப்போ எஸ்டர்டேன்றது நேத்து. அப்போ வென், அப்போ இது வந்து வென் ஈ ஜாயின்ட் அப்படின்னு வரும். இது வந்து ஹவ். ஓகே. தென் ஈ லுக்டு எவ்ரிவேர், ஈ லுக்டு எவ்ரிவேர். அவன் அங்கே பார்த்துட்டு இருந்தா, எவ்ரிவேர் எல்லா இடத்துலையும் பார்த்துட்டு இருந்தா. அப்போ ஹவ் ஈ லுக், வேர் டிட் ஈ லுக்டு, வேர், வேர் டிட் ஈ லுக், ஈ லுக் எவ்ரிவேர். ஈ ஏட் பிஸ்கெட், ஏட் பிஸ்கெட்ஸ் ட்வாய்ஸ் எ டே. ஈ ஏட்ஸ் பிஸ்கெட்ஸ் ட்வாய்ஸ் எ டே. ஸோ ஹவ் ஆஃபன், ட்வாய்ஸ் எ டே, ரெண்டு தடவைக்கு, ஒரு நாளைக்கு ரெண்டு தடவை சாப்பிட்டான்னு சொல்கிறேன் இல்லையா. ஹவ் ஆஃபன் அது மாதிரி க்வெஸ்சன் கேட்கணும். அந்த வேர்ப் என்ன பண்ணுறாங்க, he ate biscuit. How often he ate a biscuit? Twice a day. So in the mari a verb explains about the, tells about the how, when, where and how often. Okay, now in this they are given the choose the correct answer and here they are given the pictures, some of the pictures they are given, that is angrily, angry man face, and then a cat, a boy, one man is being speaking and here they are celebrating. So we have to see, take, if you got a book, take a book page number 82. So you have to see his face. His face is happily, sadly, angrily. Appa angrily tick pannunga. A, choose the correct answer. If you got the book, you take a book children and note down this, choose the correct answer. Choose the correct answer. Page number 82. Page number 82 you can take. So first one is happily. First man picture on the happily. Sadly. Abdina four options kuttirukanga. You can tick angrily. You can tick the answer in the box. Okay. Angrily. Then a cat picture is there. Walks fast. Walks beautifully. Walks harshly. So you can write
cat walks beautifully. So you can take this answer in the box if you got the book. Beautifully, and a cat picture irukkadala, I am just writing this. One boy is reading, he reads sadly, reads joyfully, reads angrily. So he reads joyfully. Avan sandoshama padikiran adhu. So he reads joyfully. So you tick this answer in the box. Then speak silently, speak rarely, speak loudly. Yeah, this man is speak loudly. Then fifth one, celebrate sadly, celebrate sorrowfully, celebrate cheerfully. So you can write celebrate cheerfully. Okay, then circle and write the adverbs. Next one is the same page. Circle and write the adverbs. So yeah, they are given some of the sentences. First one, he laughed merrily. Avan eppadi sirichan? He laughed merrily. So underline this and in the dash la merrily nu ezhudanum. Unga book la apdi dhaan irukku. Okay, then we will leave today. How often he will go today? He will leave today. So you can write today. Okay, yeah. Then third one, suddenly the old man fainted. How often kekkuram illaya, appo suddenly adu underline pannunga. The old man fainted. So appo edhu anga adverb? Suddenly. Appo the suddenly idhukku nera dash la you have to write suddenly the old man fainted. I am waiting here. I am waiting here. So appo idhula edhu illa adverb? Here. So you can write here. Then I drink coffee thrice. I drink coffee thrice. So appena varo thrice underline panunga. Okay, so this is the adverb. Then page number 83, here in this, pick and write the, pick and write adverbs to complete the sentences, to complete the sentences. Here they are given loudly, beautifully, brilliantly, bravely, and cunningly. Okay, my dog barks loudly. So you have to take and write male in the words of party. My dog barks loudly. Okay, she won the game. She won the game. She won the game brilliantly. So in the box they are given the adverbs. You have to choose the adverb and write. She colored the picture beautifully. She colored the picture
beautifully. Then fourth one, the lion fought bravely. The lion fought bravely. Then a jackal cheated the crow. A jackal cheated the crow. Cunningly. Okay, so these are the adverbs they are given. So you have to select the adverbs from the box and write it children. Okay. So that's all children. This is the adverb for the page number 83. So mark down everything what all I gave and what all I have written in this. So copy down everything in your classwork and go through this and complete the classwork in this. We will see in the next class children. Thank you.